We first broke this story of Ms. Dunlap, who was physically assaulted by police in North Carolina. And this physical assault led to nothing, meaning they did not charge her with anything. As a matter of fact, a supervisor said, let her go. Now she has filed a lawsuit. Here's the update. Now, remember the incident. Here it is.
Please stop. Can you unhook? Can y'all stop? Okay. Like, what are you doing?
You got her seatbelt?
Not yet.
Please stop. Ma'am.
Stop.
Please let go of me.
Stop resisting.
Please, I'm not resisting. You got
you
me.
Are. Yeah, you are.
You got me.
Okay, all right.
What are you doing?
Come on in.
Ma'am, okay, don't drag me out.
Then get out of the car.
I will if you
I've
will
asked
let,
you multiple times.
If you will release
car.
My arm.
Get out of the car.
If you will release my arm,
ma'am,
I will. If you will
vehicle.
Release my arm,
step
I will. Because you're grabbing my arm very tightly.
You okay.
Now you're grabbing my arm very tightly.
She ain't going nowhere now.
Look. Let me go.
Okay.
And yeah. I'll get the f out.
Okay. Step back.
Don't start.
I do right
okay.
There.
Okay, it sure is.
Okay,
and you're not getting it because I know I haven't did anything
okay,
wrong.
Step back the car.
Okay.
How many times have I asked you
not? Please, let go of me.
Stop.
What are you doing?
Right.
Let go of me. Let go of me.
Ms. Dunlap was the property manager on a property where she was taking pictures of trash that had been placed on said property. She was told to do this by her supervisor. She was well within her parameters as an employee. The officers decided to roll up on private property without any provocation or even suspicion of criminal activity, tried to rip her out of the vehicle while she was still in her seatbelt. Once again, supervisor arrives after she is arrested, handcuffed, placed inside of a squad car. Supervisor comes and says, why did you lock her up? She committed no crime, let her go. She interviewed with us, here's part of that interview.
And after they were trying to put me in handcuffs, the one detective that you see actually on my recording, she was trying to take my phone out my hand. So it was literally, she's literally trying to wrestle me to take my phone out my hand to stop my recording. They put me in handcuffs, threw me up against the trunk of the car. And after that, I started hyperventilating so bad that I started vomiting. After that, that's when their sergeant arrived, asked if I needed medical attention, which I declined.
All right, let's put up the picture of Ms. Dunlap and one of the cops who assaulted her. Ja'Lana Dunlap Banks accused the Fayetteville, North Carolina police of assaulting her on September 6th, 2022. We received an exclusive to that video. A North Carolina woman is now suing. She's now suing its police department and the officers for false imprisonment and negligence for an incident she said left her traumatized and bruised. Ja'Lana Dunlap Banks also accused Fayetteville police officer Ryan Haddock and detective Amanda Bell of assault and battery. Video of the encounter shows Bell forcefully gripping Dunlap Banks' wrist in an effort to pull the woman from the vehicle. Here's a quote from Ms. Dunlap Banks. I really just want to speak up for people who can't speak up for themselves, she said at a press conference on Tuesday, October 25th. I just want to make it clear that you have to speak up for yourself. You have to demand respect, whether they wear a badge or whether they're just in regular clothes. And if you're wearing that badge, if you're wearing a uniform, then you're supposed to protect us, not harm innocent people. I completely concur with this young lady and the sentiment expressed. On September 6th, Ms. Dunlap Banks was in an empty private lot taking photos of the grounds for a property management company where she works. She paid for garbage pickup on the property and was taking pictures to show her boss. Fayetteville Police Chief Gina Hawkins, who is also named in the federal lawsuit, said the officers were pursuing a fugitive in the area and wanted to check to see if Dunlap Banks was involved. That is their cover story. She was released after the officers identified and cleared her. Attorney, civil rights attorney Harry Daniels, said the officers treated Dunlap Banks aggressively because of her skin color. The lawsuit, which was filed on Tuesday, October 25th, argues that North Carolina is not a stop and identify state. So Dunlap Banks was not required to show proof of identification and had already given officers her full name. Now, let me remind you of what that means. There are places, there are states that are stop and identify states by statute, which means there's a state law that allows the police, without provocation, without suspicion, and without cause, they can literally approach you and say, identify yourself. Now, even the states that have such laws, such as Alabama, those laws do not apply on private property, only in public places. North Carolina has no law at all that allows the police to do what they did to this young lady. After this video went viral, she lost her job. She lost her job. So we have been helping her with the GoFundMe page. Let's put that up. Just a goal of, I think, 5,000. If you would like to contribute to help this young lady who stood up for her rights, who did absolutely nothing wrong and was adversely impacted because of the actions of rogue cops, you can make a contribution today. Wheels of justice starting to move in the right direction. Now, remember, when we first covered this story, Internal Affairs said they were investigating after we covered it. Before that, there was absolutely no movement from IA. Yes, she filed a complaint immediately. She filed a complaint. She got nowhere until we covered the story. Now, what does this mean? This means that hopefully there will be transition and maybe even a transformation of policy in that department. David, thoughts here?
I'm Dr. Richey. We did the story on Dr. Dunlap, on Ms. Dunlap a couple of weeks ago, right after you guys did. And I'm glad to hear that she's now filing the lawsuit, because we had legal experts tell us at the time she has a very strong case for her lawsuit. And I think the evidence that this is racism and racially motivated is clear, because think about it this way. If she had been a white property manager, would the police have been so quickly to grab her, to demand ID, or would they have taken the time to say, okay, we've got your name, we've got your license, we're gonna actually use that Google thing and check out if you are who you say you are. But instead, they were in such a rush because they had their preconceived biases that because she's African American, she matches the skin color of some fugitive that they may be looking for, they're not gonna wait a second. That is racism right there.
Yeah, and think about the irony of their cover story. They're not saying she fit the description of a fugitive. They're just saying they wanted to do this to see if she had information about the fugitive. Well, that means they could have stopped anybody. You can randomly stop any citizen and say, you are in knowledge of, or you have knowledge of, a fugitive that we're searching for. It's a ridiculous cover story. It will not hold up in a court of law. And they know good and damn well what they did was not policy nor protocol. That's why the supervisor said you have to let her go. We'll bring you the updates as they come.